Hi, welcome to this video about NCS 5500 route scale. Here are the topics we'll cover today. How we can learn a full internet view on base systems. How we will monitor the ASICS resources with counters and streaming telemetry. And finally, how we will handle internet growth. Let's get started. In this video, we'll show you the routing scale of the NCS 5500, and more particularly, we talk about the LAN card and system not using external TCAM. For instance, we are talking about the 36x100 GigE LAN card, the 18H18F, the coherent DWDM LAN card, and the MACsec LAN card. None of them are using external TCAM, just the memory inside the forwarding ASIC. Same thing for the fixed form factor platform, 5501 here. Also, we have one version of the 5502, not using external TCAM. Here, the 55A1-24H, and finally, one version of the 55A1-36H exists without external TCAM. The demo will be fairly simple. We will have 15 times the internet advertised inside a router, and this router will be a 5508 chassis with a LAN card, not using external TCAM. We are talking about real internet routes here, something recorded through real V4 and V6 internet views. So we will have 15 times the internet V4 and V6 advertised to the box and received by our BGP process. All this information is installed inside what we call the edge read-in. This memory will be after the RPL application. This information is going into the local read, and finally the local read will populate the routing information base. This base is also populated with other protocols like OSPF, ISIS, or even the connected and the statics. All these protocols or sources will populate the RIP. Then the RIP is passing route information to the FIB and to what we call the DPA. DPA is data plane agent. This data plane agent will use address family, V4 and V6, but also prefix length to decide where the route should be stored inside the forwarding ASICs. For instance, we will have different bases, the LPM, the LEM, but also in some other LAN cards, we'll have the external TCAM here. That's where the prefixes are stored, but also we'll have the next stop information stored here, and also the load balancing information, and the encapsulation database is also one that will be populated here. So it's going to be very important to leverage the different size of these databases. And to do so, we will use the different prefixes and different prefix length we have to optimize the distribution. So let me show you now how we're going to do that with a real router. This is our 5508 with the LAN card we'll use, which is in slot 2. That's the one here. That is the 36x100 we will use for this test. Show BGP sum will show me how many prefixes are advertised from each neighbors. I have 15 of them advertising the full internet view, V4, but also V6. So BGP summary. So if I do a show BGP simply like this, for each prefix, I will have information of next stop, AS path, but also local pref, metrics, etc. All the BGP attributes. I will have the same also for IPv6 unicast. This is my V6 routing table and all the path. So I'm talking about real routes here. That's a use case where the router is used in a peering role. I can also check the number of path I have in total. With the show BGP scale, I will have number of prefix V6 and V4, total 760K, and the number of path is almost 10 million. And we can go actually much higher. And this is a memory it represents inside the routing processor. There is also ways to show this information with streaming telemetry. The router is generating streams of counters to a collector, and I can see in real time my V4 table size, V6 table, but also the number of paths, 9.9, almost 10 million paths. So in real time, I can see that, and I can see how it evolves. That's for the BGP part. Now, if I want to take a look at my RIB, I will just simply do a show route. And here, I will see that some routes have been learned through BGP, some others have been learned through static. And if I do the same thing for IPv6, I will see that I have routes learned by, they are connected, they are local, and some others are BGP. So this is the different processes that have been populating my RIB table. Now, this information is passing through the feed and the DPA. And here, the important information will be the prefix distribution, because we want to optimize the way we're going to sort the routes. So I type show BG, so DPA resources IP route, location 0/2, which is where my LAN card is. And I can see, depending on the prefix size, how many entries I have. And that's very important, because that's really where we'll do the optimization. And same things exist through for IPv6. I will say the most important one for IPv6 being /48 present here. So that's all the DPA is receiving. And depending on the prefix length, I will decide where it should go, LEM, LPM, etc. So I will take a look at my controllers, show controller NPU resources, LEM, for example, location 02. And here, I can see the maximum size. For LEM, I can store up to 786K entries. And what is currently used? For, let's say, 410K for roughly 52%. Okay? And for LPM now, I can see that I estimate the maximum number of entries at 430K, and I currently occupy 81% of this capability. This number, 430, is actually dynamic depending on the prefix distribution. It varies between 350 and 450, more or less, depending on the way you are sorting routes. So I do have still 19% available here. Same information is available through streaming telemetry. I can monitor in real time how many LEM entries I'm using, how many LPM entries I'm using. So that's really showing that 15 times internet can be stored in a non-TCAM system and still use only 52% of the LEM and 91% of the LPM, knowing that most of the new prefixes will come here, /24, /23, they are storing here. How does it work exactly? By default, all the prefixes are going into the LPM aside the /32. Not very useful for internet distribution, where we have a lot of /24, /23, not that many /32. So that's why we've done the first improvement, which is a default mode when you run the system. We are using 32 and 24 in LEM, and the rest goes in LPM. And for IPv6, all the /48 are going in LEM, and the rest goes in LPM. That way, we are leveraging the largest database, which is the LEM. But it's not enough. We did some other improvement, something we call the Internet Optimized Mode. And this mode is simply changing the order of operation in LEM and LPM lookup. We don't change anything on the IPv6. All the /48 are going in LEM. But on the IPv4 side, we no longer give a lot of importance to /32. It's going into LPM. We are giving more precedence or more importance to /20, 23, and 24. All this will go inside this LEM, and that's a good thing because that's the most important route population on internet. So the question will be, how far can it go? We are using this gross projection based on the information available on these two Twitter accounts. BGP 4 and 6 table are showing every week the distribution of routes depending on the prefix length. That's a good thing because we can see a trend and decide which one are growing for IPv4 and IPv6. We see that /24 is the fastest growing population, and for IPv6, /48 is the biggest one. we can see that in the future it will go like this for LEM and LPM, and we can also identify where we're going to run out of resource. LPM, we have 786 entries, K entries, that's something around here. And for LPM, we have 430K, which is something around here. So we take the earliest date, and that will be something between 21 and 2022. So we can safely say that we can use this line card with the current growth projection between 2021 and 2022.
Thanks for watching.